Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to J&K Bank Q1 FY 2021 earnings conference call hosted by Prabhudas Lilladher Private Limited. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touch-tone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Pritesh Bumb from Prabhudas Lilladher Private Limited. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to welcome the management of Jammu and Kashmir Bank, represented by Mr. R.K. Chhibbal, who is the Chairman and Managing Director. Management will give their brief remarks on the Q1 results, and then we'll move to the Q&A. I would like to hand over the call to the Managing Director. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you. Welcome. A very good afternoon and a very warm welcome to all the participants. I hope all of you would have received our earnings update for the June 2020, which is also hosted on the bank's website. The first quarter of the current financial year was almost completely marked by the fallout of COVID-19 pandemic, with devastating domino effect percolating from the real economy to the financial sector. As every activity was brought to a grinding halt amid imposition of lockdown throughout the country and world at large. Though the economic sector are reopening cautiously after the unlock phase was announced, yet it will take quite some time to restore the business as usual status for a number of severely affected sectors like aviation, tourism, hospitality, and other financial sectors. A blanket pursuit to aftermath of the pandemic was the reported unprecedented crumbling of the national GDP by almost 1/4. For us in J&K Beauty, it was a more protracted and prolonged period of disruption, which we started early in the month of August 2019. A number of relief measures were announced by the government to ease the hardship and support the borrower through the cash crunch period with initiative under Atmanirbhar Bharat, like rupees 3 lakh crore GECL, rupees 20,000 crore MSME subordinated stress fund, restructuring of stress loans, in addition to the granting of moratorium period for payment of principal and interest, and then creation of FITL for accrued interest on working capital loan during that moratorium period. These measures are somewhat moderating the disruption both of the targeted economy sector. However, the viability of this economic pursuit till resumption of usual business activity shall be the key in deciding the future and going concern status. Consequently, their ability to serve debt obligations. Coming back to my own J&K Beauty, J&K Bank performance for the June 2020 quarter, I feel we have fared well in face of much spent beyond the COVID-19 crisis and despite all odds, have been able to post positive bottom line, a modest one. This assumes significance as we made further provision of rupees 147 crore for COVID-related stress during Q1, in addition to an equal amount we provided the last quarter of the last financial year. The bank has recorded improvement on a number of parameters, some of which I would like to highlight here. The most important, NPA coverage ratio of the bank was around 80.93% as on June 2020, as against 66.61% last June, and is even higher by 2.34 percentage point from March 2020 level. At the same time, the net NPA ratio of the bank has considerably reduced to 3.05% as against 1.36% recorded for the corresponding period, that is last fiscal, and 3.4% recorded in March 2020. Aided by the lower cost of deposit, that is 4.39% during June quarter, we are able to maintain the NIM above 3.50% threshold in spite of the drastic reduction in lending rate linked to internal benchmark as well as external benchmark. The total business of the bank stood at 1,64,461 crore. There is still a growth of around 5%. And when we compare with the corresponding period of the previous year, the deposit of the bank have increased by 12% to around 99,691 crore from 88,963 crore recorded last year, while as the advances stood at rupees 65,179 crore for Q1 of the financial year 2021. CASA component of the bank has increased by increasing deposit of 20% in savings as well, growing by 22%. The deposit growth in JNK UT has been recorded at 14%, while as a credit growth in the UT 10% on a YOY basis. The CASA ratio of the bank has improved to 53.7% from 50.20% recorded last year. By and large, in the JNK UT, we are doing well. On the both sides, deposits as well as liability side were in a double digit. Cost management already put in place has started yielding dividends, as is evident from the reduction of other OPEX for June quarter by 12% on a YO basis and more pronounced 22% over March 2020 quarter. For maximum coverage of eligible borrowers under GECL scheme, we proactively are ensuring that majority of our customer businesses avail the available facility to tide over the current situation, cash flow issue, and be able to resume their operation. So far, more than 46,000 borrowers have availed the loan under GECL scheme, and we have disbursed around 1,561 crore. That will include most chunk in the JNK UT, around 1,334 CR, and rupees 257 crore in the rest of country. During the previous con call, some investor had desired some additional detail and clarity with regard to the figure of SMA account, where the bank had extended the facility, a moratorium, and asset classification relaxation as per regulatory guidelines. Let me clarify that as on last day of February 2020, SMA portfolio of the bank was around 10,290 CR, but there are good recoveries in the succeeding month, and most of these accounts got regularized with amount left in SMA 0, 1, and 2, getting reduced to just around 2,948 CR as on 31st March 2020, for which 10% provision has been made, 5% in March and 5% in the Q1 quarter, aggregating around 295 CR. From the disastrous ramification of the lockdown and business disruption of a few months witnessed by the financial sector in the country, you may be wondering as to how the JNK Bank have been able to survive in a troubled geography for such a long time. Here I want to emphasize some peculiarity of the JNK economy and a unique feature of JNK Bank that have enabled us to sustain and thrive regardless of the 3 decades of turmoil. You must appreciate that JNK economy numbers are mainly driven by services sector, which contributes 56% of the GHVA, while agriculture contributes 16%, industry 28%. In agriculture, major portion is contributed by the commercial horticulture and apple crop. Among industries, electricity, gas, and water supply constitute around 35%. Under services, public administration and defense account for around 27%, while trade, transport, stores contribute more than 20%. Contrary to common belief, tourism, hotel, restaurant only contribute 6% to the GSVA number. That is, trade industry is predominantly MSME with over 4 lakh units, and the granular composition of borrowers is evident from the relatively very small ticket size. Akin to this structure, JK Bank's exposure to the tourism, hotel and restaurant is just 2% of our loan book. In contrast, retail loan comprising mostly housing loan, consumer durable, vehicle, consumption loan constitute 35% of loan book of the bank, and majority of these loans are availed by our government employees of JNK, UT and Ladakh are granted by them, and the delinquency in this portfolio is just hardly 1%. The other strong point, in my opinion, in the balance sheet of the bank is its huge retail liability franchise, which is highly stable and economical. The patronage of the UT government lend the bank creditability and the general public acceptance, making it a household name, enjoying immense brand equity in the UT. This is further bolstered by it being designated as RBI's agent for carrying out government business in the twin duty of Ladakh as well as JNK, with the lead bank responsibility around 12 districts of the 20 districts of the JNK UT. The UT government has resumed its focus on a slew of governmental initiatives for accelerated rollout and the mega investor meet, which could not be held last year and is being rescheduled for attracting investment to the UT, especially in an area of infrastructure development, industry promotion, incentivization of socio-economic sectors like commercial, horticulture, tourism, arts and crafts, aimed at achieving socio-economic development, employment generation and improving living standard in the UT. The UT government is seriously contemplating a comprehensive leap package for rehabilitation of a local economy, and toward this, and a high level committee headed by the advisor, the Honorable LG, was constituted, of which I am also a member. The committee has recently likely to submit its report proposing a wide ranging relief package with a host of financial, administrative and policy measures aimed at the revival of the economy of the JNK UT and rehabilitation of the affected sector. The bank's board of directors have approved raising of capital CET1 of ₹3,500 crore and tier 2 around 1,000 crore for maintaining adequate capital with a sufficient buffer for fueling future growth and ensuring regulatory compliance also. The proposal is being put before the member for approval in our ensuing AGM meeting, likely to be held on 28th of September 2020, and the mobilization is being planned in a phased manner so as to ensure securing the shareholder value while achieving the capital augmentation objective. Government of JNK UT has assured full support and infusion of further capital as per requirement. In the last financial year also, the JNK government UT has contributed 500 crore. We are also contemplating to sell the residual stake in the PNB Metalife and raising some portion of the capital by exploring the option of ESPS in that order. Though the spread of the infection may continue for some time, yet the initiative of the UT government on the annual are sure to accelerate the economic traction. We are already witnessing an overall improvement in the working cycle, resuming an economic activity gathering pace. We are looking forward to further fortify our CASA, retail component on the deposit side, while on the advances front, we are looking at a low double-digit YY growth rate with main contribution from JNK, UT and Ladakh. A well-defined and more comprehensive guidance can be expected post-September result with stability returning to business cycle. We, at the management of the JNK Bank, acknowledge your support and trust and we expect it to continue in the coming days also. I will be glad to know, have your question. Thank you. Thank you very much. That is from my side.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Manish Otswal from Nirmal Bang Securities. Please go ahead. Manish, your line is in talk mode. You can go ahead, please. We would request the current participant to unmute yourself if muted from the handset. We would request the participants to please press star and one to ask a question. The next question is from the line of Bhavik Shah from BNK Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Hi, sir. Good afternoon. This is Jay here. Sir, if you can tell about what was the loan in rupees crore under moratorium as of August end, and within which how many have not paid any single EMI in the last 6 months? That is the first question, sir.
Okay. You are talking about which period?
Sir, the loans under moratorium as of August end. So the moratorium has ended. But what is the loans under moratorium as of August end?
Good afternoon, sir. Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir.
We have offered that special benefit to all the account holders, and the question will be clear how much they have accepted the moratorium and were not accepted. That will be clear by the end of this month. But the asset classification benefit, which has been given by the bank, that was just 3,000 crores at the end of March. And the bank has also
It is not very clear, so there is a lot of echo.
Just a moment, please.
Yes, sir.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the asset classification benefit which was given by the bank was almost 3,000 crores. And the bank has already provided for that portion. And out of that portfolio, as on date, the amount under CFS is only 2,000 crores now.
Sorry, so this is the where you have made 10% provisioning, right? That is,
yeah.
This is what you. So that is okay. I think, sir, what I want to know is the how much of the loans are under moratorium?
Yeah, we have offered the moratorium as per RBI guidelines. We have offered the moratorium to the all account holders. And this will be clear by the end of this month or first week of October. How many people have accepted it? That will be clear thereafter only.
But sir, the moratorium has already ended.
Yeah.
All other banks, they have given a number either at June end, July end, August end. We would have some number either at June end or July end. I mean, that number will also be helpful, sir, even if it is June end or July end.
Yeah, we have offered this facility, as already said, we have offered this facility to all account holders. And these days, since end of the moratorium, we are converting that
loan into a FITL or extending the moratorium, and the thing is will be clear by month end only.
But there would be some numbers, sir, as of June end, right, which are the under moratorium.
Actually, just give me one day or so, I will let you know the exact figure. Huh?
Second, sir, what is your sense on the restructuring? Now, RBI has allowed one-time restructuring of corporate as well as personal loan. A rough number, I mean, as you said, there is a lot of time before you as to how many will qualify or how many will come for restructuring. But what is your rough sense, sir? Can it be like 10%? Can it be like 5%? What is the rough number that we should be keeping in mind that this much percentage number could be restructured?
Mr. Rano, respond please.
At this stage, exact number we can't give, but since it's only SMA-0 accounts up to 30-day delinquency are eligible for this restructuring for personal loans or other loans, we are issuing the circular. Within a day or two, we will be able to convey the figures exactly. We are not collecting the data as it is. There are a lot of other things also attached with this, whether to go, whether how much moratorium is to be given, how much interest accrued to be given. There are a lot of things attached to this. You have to give us 1-2 days, we will collect the data. Today we are issuing the circular for this.
In the JNK UT, mostly we are having a personal loan as well as a facility allowed to JNK government employee. So rest we will definitely let you know.
No, so I take your point that the loan given to JNK said government employees, they are much safer, they are like quasi sovereign. But in other portfolios, sir, what is your sense as to how many of them come for restructuring?
Basically, the personal loan portfolio of the bank is mostly dependent upon the employees of the J&K government, which accounts for not less than 80% of the total personal loan portfolio of the bank. And they have got the salaries in time, and there is no issue of structuring those advances. Then remains the rest 15 or 20%. And we don't see much movement in that portfolio also, because we have in most of the cases we have received the installment, and there are hardly arrears in any account. Very few accounts will be here. And then there is the corporate portfolio, which is SMA 0 or non-SMA. That there we have to make calculations, because we are issuing the guidelines, Runji has already said. We are issuing the guidelines today in pursuant to RBI circular, which was issued on 7th of the September. So within 3-4 days, we will be able to calculate what we can do, how much we can do in that portfolio.
By and large, there are around 50,000 accounts, and amount is around 3,000 CR.
So what is this amount, sir?
Likely to be restructured around 50,000 accounts, and amount is around 3,000 CR.
Okay. And this is for entire bank, right? JNK portfolio as well as non-JNK portfolio.
I'm talking about the bank only, entire bank.
For the entire bank, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That is very helpful, sir. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, sir. I will come back.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Kunal Kohli from Bowhead India. Please go ahead.
So thank you for this opportunity, sir. Just to clarify, you said above 3,000 crores, broadly, would be eligible for restructuring. But would you expect mass-scale NPAs or a large NPL, which will not get restructured because they are unable to pay, over the next 1-2 quarters? Or would that be a small number?
Arun, please respond, Karna. Can you repeat the question, please?
Sir, you said that 3,000 crore may be allowed to restructure, but there will be SMA 1 and SMA 2 accounts which will not be allowed to restructure.
Yes,
so my
yes,
question was, for those SMA 1 and SMA 2 accounts which are not allowed to be restructured, you know?
These would be non-SMA, non-SMA and SMA 0 accounts. It will be restructured. Can be restructured.
But SMA 1 and SMA 2 can't be, and those guys in SMA 1 and SMA 2 which can't be restructured and don't have the means to pay, I assume they'll become NPL for you, right? So would that be a large number or would that be a small number in your view?
Hey, we have already this provided this funding support due to COVID, due to this impact of COVID-19 through our different schemes. There was GCL, which was applicable this for SMA 1 client, up to SMA 1 client. Then there is CGSSG, Credit Guarantee Scheme for Subordinate Debt, which is applicable for SMA 2 and NPA accounts. Then there is our own scheme, J&K Business Support, this scheme for COVID-19, where we can provide 10% of working capital limit. We have different schemes for this to this provide liquidity support to such borrowers.
And sir, so would you expect large scale NPLs, in next 1-2 quarters?
Yes, can you repeat, please?
So would you expect large scale NPLs in next 1-2 quarters?
As on 31st August 2020, our this SMA figure was around 2000 crore.
Okay.
And number of accounts involved were 43,746.
Okay.
Yes.
Got it, sir. And I think for your state, generally the NCMA number is higher because of the retail and the SME customers, right? So this is in line with the past. This is not very high compared to history.
No. Nothing like this.
So you don't expect large NPLs, at least in the near future, right?
No, sir. We have different schemes to provide liquidity support to distressed borrowers. Their liquidity is stressed due to COVID-19, and we have further information under GS scheme. As on date, we have just provided liquidity support up to 1591 crore to around 46,000 borrowers. Out of this, in debt of India, this is 257 crore. In J&K alone, it is 1,334 crore as on date.
And sir, the apple trade wouldn't need support, right? Because their business must not have been impacted.
On agriculture, there's no impact, virtually zero impact on horticulture, agriculture items.
Okay. And sir, as far as sir, the government plans and support is concerned, do you think that in terms of various measures, the government of Jammu and Kashmir may help the, you know, the account holders of Jammu and Kashmir or the people of Jammu and Kashmir?
Yes.
Would allow...
Chairman sir has already briefed all about this subcommittee which was formed by LG sir regarding this deliberations in that subcommittee, and the government is providing intervention support to all the affected borrowers.
So how big would that be, interest subvention? You know, is it like they're paying the interest on the behalf of these affected
people? At present, we cannot comment. But the committee has recommended certain revival and survival plan, and now it is up to the J&K government to decide which way they will move. But by and large, I think they will come out to the rescue of other people.
And they could provide guarantees also to you, like the central government had provided guarantees?
Yeah, at present, I cannot say unless the final word from the LG office only.
And sir, by when do you expect? Would it come before the next quarterly results?
Expecting any time.
Oh, any time now. Okay.
Yeah.
May I add here, this year we are going to have added income from our agriculture and horticulture sector. Because this year the fruit import is not taking place and the apple crop is in huge demand. And we have already seen rates moving 3 times this year. And the crop is also good. And we expect a good income from this horticulture sector this year.
And so this apple import is being sold from China or from where?
No. Earlier on, the apple used to be imported from US, New Zealand, Australia. But this year, there are restrictions on the import, and the Kashmir apple is in great demand this year.
Lovely. And sir, as far as your salary cost is concerned, what is the recurring salary cost number we should take? And as far as your capital raising plans are concerned, By when would you raise this capital? Because the stock price is so subdued, so would the larger dilution happen at the current price, or would it be after 1-2 quarters when the conditions are a little better?
Actually, the capital raising is being phased in a way that the shareholders' value, it doesn't get diluted that to a large extent. So the first thing that the bank is contemplating will be the sale of some inherent values that are there. Like, we have got this PNB MetLife residual stake that is 60 crores. That is expected to yield some 360 crores. So 300 will go to the bottom line only. Then after that, we are looking at this ESPS. In that order, and after that, the preferential this allotment to government, the follow-up issue, the QIP, the public issue, those will be actually phased after this. So it will be phased in a manner that the shareholder value won't be diluted at the current level.
Understood. So bulk of the capital raise won't happen now. Even from the government, will take at least, you know, maybe last quarter usually it happens, right?
Exactly, they do it like that. They infuse in the last quarter of the year every year. So actually, they will be doing that only this year also. So there are other options which are being actually prioritized, which will be taken up first, where the shareholders' value doesn't get diluted. Yeah.
And sir, as far as the salary cost is concerned, what kind of number for the salary cost should we take for this year?
You see, we have provided for the wage revision. The bank has already provided adequately during this quarter. Also, we have made a provision of 80 crores towards the wage revision, and there are other things being done. Like, we are rationalizing a lot of expenditures, rationalizing the staff. So there will be some savings on that front also. But then the savings, it grows at almost 10% every year. This employee cost, it has been growing at 10% almost every year. So that will be the figure for the time being.
So, sir, for this year, financial year, whatever you showed in Q1, would that be like your normal salary cost? Can we multiply it by 4, or were there any one-offs in the salary cost?
No, there won't be any one-offs, because you see, for the wage division, we have already made sufficient provisions. So it will be a normal hike, normal rise.
No, sir, the Q1 numbers which you have reported, what I'm trying to understand, is this the run rate going forward, or were there any one-offs in this Q1 employee cost?
No, there are no one-offs other than this 80 crores, this provision that we have made towards the wage revision, because there might have been some shortfall in the provisions that we had made last year. For the full year, we had made 176 crores of provisions towards the wage revision. So going by that, then it could have been 45 crores for the first quarter, but then we have made 80 crores. So there was a component of 35 crores in excess of what we had provided in the previous quarters.
Okay, so if I've understood you correctly, going forward, so there's a 135 crore one-off in this quarter.
You see,
so
exactly.
If I have to figure out...
So you add 10% to the last year, that is 1880 crores, so it will be round about 2050 crores.
Great, sir. Thank you so much. It's very helpful.
Sure.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Siddharth Basi from SGI. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Firstly, congratulations on the results. It's been a good effort considering the pandemic. I had a couple of questions. Firstly, regarding the fundraising. Is Jammu and Kashmir Bank also looking to sell some of its real estate assets that it may have in Srinagar or Kashmir to raise capital? And my second question is, the government earlier provided the capital at an equity issue of 30 rupees a share. Can we expect something around that price for the preferential issue so that the current shareholders don't suffer, or are we expecting something lower? These are my first two questions, and once these get responded to, I had one more question on the NPAs that I'll come to.
Okay, the bank is contemplating to raise capital, as you are aware, and various options are there. As my colleagues already mentioned, the monetization of assets also is on the cards. We are also envisaging, besides, as already pointed out, that stake sale of PNB MetLife. And then also we are making the balance sheet adjustments like the floating provisions that we used to keep that appropriate towards and get net NPAs. Then we are also contemplating to shift them for long-term basis entire two. That will also have an improvisation on this current capital state. And this, as my colleagues already added, that this capital addition, we are contemplating our the next 2 quarters, and it will be a long-term process, our 1 year. And in terms of this share price, yes, the bank is looking at maximizing the share value, and in those terms, looking at that, price issue will be issued and going forward.
And so if you give me guidance on the price,
one more thing which I would like to point out, that in terms of revenue reserves also, we have made an addition of around 400 crores in March, revaluation reserve, on account of revaluation reserve, that has also supplemented the capital. And in terms of this density of risk-weighted assets, on that front, the bank is quite comfortable, because if you look at in terms of PSU, corporate, NBFC and others, if you look at the overall portfolio, the density in terms is favorable, quite favorable, and because BB and below assets, they are quite lower in number, and they are particularly in the inventory of J&K Ladakh, around 2,300 crores, so that also gives us a scope of optimization of the capital.
Right. So my question firstly is very specific. J&K Bank has a lot of non-core assets in real estate in Kashmir.
Yeah.
Is J&K Bank looking to sell any of those to raise funds? Secondly, can you give me guidance on the stock price at which you are looking to raise funds?
We are contemplating to monetize, as already I said, that monetize the assets. That's also one of the options. We have identified assets. And 30-35 is the band we are looking in terms of the equity price.
All right. So 35 rupees is where you're looking to sell stake in the bank. My next question basically is with regards to some recoveries that you have made. So you made 100 crore recoveries is what you mentioned in your earnings. Now, there are a lot of things we read in the media regarding significantly politically linked accounts that have turned NPAs and money is being recovered from those. Can you shed more light on that? Is that the true fact we get to hear, that the pace of recoveries is more than what you're expecting?
Yeah, like you have heard in the news that there has been some a number of accounts, those have been you can say linked to their political interference and influence through which those have been granted. And definitely the current government, they are helping in recovery of those assets, of those bad loans. And this will give a signal to other borrowers also, other delinquent borrowers, that they will pay up.
So do you have a number on such recoveries that have happened?
The 100, you mean the 100, this recoveries of this 100 crore amount that has happened in the first quarter.
Is 100 crores politically linked amount? Or is
No, it is not. It is not linked to that, because those are some 2-3 large accounts, and once that amount is recovered, it will be a bigger amount. It will be a substantial amount. It won't be just 100 crores in a quarter. These have been smaller recoveries.
Normal recoveries.
Yeah, normal recoveries. Like in the Reliance Commercial, there has been a recovery of 9 crores. MS Infrastructure, 4 crores, Liberty Oil Mills, 4 crores, Manzoor Shahi Hotel, 3 crores. So these have been actually granular recoveries in smaller accounts.
So can you shed light on the quantum of the political recoveries that you are expecting?
But this quarter is not comfortable for recovery, no? It depends upon the improvement of the overall scenario of the COVID-19.
So recoveries that will be made in the accounts where money was given to political families. So I'm asking if you have any granularity on that number, and the kind of recoveries you're expecting from those accounts, maybe not tomorrow, but maybe 2 quarters down the line. And what role the government is playing in helping you get those recoveries?
Through their investigations and other, this, they are exerting a lot of pressure on these borrowers to pay up. So definitely, like we have got 2-3 larger accounts where this amount is liquid to them. So that may be in the range of 300 to 400 overall in the UTR J&K. And out of that 300, 400 crores, definitely maybe in the next 2-3 quarters, there may be recoveries of almost 300 crores.
Are you expecting those? Do you have any assets that are already seized by you that you may sell to recover such money?
Actually, we had already taken possession, that is through SARFAESI and other means, we had already taken possession of those assets. But now, unless and until this investigation gets over, is finalized, till then we can't go ahead with this sale of those assets or putting those under the hammer. So that will be accomplished only when this investigation is over.
But once they go under the hammer, you get 300 crores back. So essentially, the money is back to the bank in another form, if I may be correct. So it's not zero. 400 crore, zero new, I got your
zero new. Because there are a number of assets that have been created. Those assets may not have been fully completed, but there are assets available with the bank. Those have been taken. Actually, the possession has also been taken, physical as well as symbolic possession has been taken. And there are assets from the which can be monetized, which can be put under the hammer, and the bank, it won't be a 100% loss. It won't be a total loss.
Right. So basically, you're saying you'll recover about 75% value.
Almost.
And is there any timeline on that? Because you will be working with the investigating agencies as well to release the assets as soon as you can.
It will only happen because you see now the agencies are like ED is also involved, CBI is involved, ACB is involved. So there are a number of agencies involved. So it may take some more time.
Right. Right. My next question is regarding the 2,000 crores that you've mentioned. These are your total additions in NPA you're expecting because of COVID. You said 3,000 crores earlier. Now you're saying there are 2,000 crores which are under moratorium, right?
Yes, please.
So there were 3,000 crores under moratorium is what you said to my previous speaker.
Yeah.
Of which you said ki 1,000 crores already theek ho chuka.
Yes.
Ab is 2,000 crore mein, how much you are expecting slippage and how much do you think will become standard again?
Like it was 3,000 crores some 2 months back and it has now come down to 2,000 crores. We are expecting by the end of this month, maximum portion out of it will be recovered and it will be citrus free. There will be very little, not more than, I think not more than 10% out of this which can slip to NP category.
Okay. And but once the government, as you are seeing with the LG sir, giving interest subvention, all these accounts could also become standard?
That will be bonus.
So essentially, the interest on interest case on Supreme Court is not really valid for J&K Bank, considering the government may pay the interest.
If government pays, that is good. If it does not pay, still the interest on interest is a very small component, and that will not affect much.
Right. And one final clarification, aapne abhi bola ki aap price band of 35 rupees a share dekh rahe hain. To raise money from the government, am I correct?
Yeah, that is a band 30 to 35 rupees.
30 to 35. And what percentage of equity then will you dilute for that? Because 500 crore mein aapne pichle baar government ko 9% shareholding di thi to make the promoter shareholding 68.
Yeah.
Okay. And this we are accepting by next quarter, next to next quarter.
In fact, this amount also will not be issued in a single tranche. Once you come out with better numbers, you report better financials after the September quarter and December quarter, definitely we foresee an appreciation in the price of this stock. And again, we will not be diluting fully at this 30-35 level. Maybe in later phases, there may be a better pricing available and accordingly, it will be phased.
Okay, just one last question on the books of J&K Bank. Since J&K obviously is the oldest bank in Kashmir, must be having huge real estate assets. I am more interested in it to get to know the real estate assets that J&K Bank has on its books. Not at book value, but market value. What is the valuation of those real estate assets, the buildings and the land in Srinagar, etc.?
You see, it is there in the balance sheet itself because what has happened, you must have seen that we revalued these assets in March this year. So these are actually at fair value as on date. So you
what's
can.
What's the fair value?
Pardon?
What's the fair value according to you?
2,000 crores as on date.
Thank you, Siddharth. We would request you to please come back in the question queue for any follow-up questions, as we have several participants waiting for their turn. The next question is from the line of Gaurav Agarwal from Mohit India. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. Very good commentary from your side after so many quarters. All the best for future quarters. Actually,
sure.
So just a couple of questions on your P&L. So you know, you make a pre-provision profits of around 400 crores, and now you are already done with the COVID-related provisions. And you know, even on the aging side, you are 80-81% PCR provided. So how do you see next 2-3 quarters in terms of your provisions? You know, considering we make 400 crores of pre-provision profit. So do in what is in your best estimation would be the run rate for your provisions and hence the PAT?
Just a moment.
Good evening. As far as provisions are concerned, we are comfortable on the provisions, both for the NPAs, NPIs, and the other general provisions. So the next quarters, we don't see any stress out coming out of it. For the salary and all, we are well provided for. So I think we are comfortable, more than comfortable for the next quarters on provisions.
So ma'am, this quarter we made 266 crore rupees of provisions. These are your NPA related provisions I'm talking about, not the employee or the tax related. It is only the NPA one I'm talking about right now. So where do you see this 266 crore number, you know, in the next 2-3 quarters?
Rather, I would say should be more or less stable, not more than that, because we've already provided for the 10% as per the regulatory guidelines. And even in case of need be, in case some fresh NPAs do happen, we've already provided for a 10%.
So actually, ma'am, you should be giving a slightly lower guidance, right? Because you are already 140 crore rupees of COVID, you don't need to provide from next quarter onwards. And if I take out that 140 crore number from the current provision number which you have made for Q1, it comes to around 120 crore. So when you are saying that it will remain here about, do you refer to 120 crore rupees of normalized provision or you are referring to 260 crore rupees of provisions which you have done in Q1?
See, sir, I'm taking over from ma'am. Good evening. You were asking about the position of our provisions in the next 3 quarters. So I would like to share with you that in the September quarter, on aging front and small accounts which may slip, we may have a requirement of nearly 250 crores. Then similarly in December, we go down to only 91 crores. And in March 21, we would see a requirement of 191 crores approximately. And the total requirement, which comes out to nearly 540-533 odd crores. And this is for the next 3 quarters. And sir, we don't see any major issues on account of the accounts where we require huge kind of this aging requirement is not there. Only a couple of accounts in March and a couple of accounts in September. So that would be that would suffice, sir. We don't require anything else further.
One thing I will add here, what madam has said, the total requirement up to March is almost 500 crore. But for this, we have cushion of 300 crore, the 10% which we already we have kept.
Sorry, sir, I couldn't get this. Can you please come again?
Madam, the total requirement of provision of almost 500 crores for next quarter
on aging
side. But on the same side, we don't see any huge slippages. So the 300 crores which we have already kept as a 10% on the stressed asset, that we will get reversed up by the end of March.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. And ma'am, would it be you know available this rating profile of your bank like JNK and outside JNK, AAA, AA?
Yeah, of course.
Yes,
just
please,
a second. Just
please,
a second.
Please.
Is it on the entire book, ma'am, or it is only of the corporate loan?
No, it is on the entire book.
The rating profile would be on the corporate books. Yeah.
As I already
mentioned that in terms of the density of the risk-weighted assets, the bank is quite comfortable. Because if you look at the PSUs, we have a portfolio of around 6,351 crores for PSUs and around this 5,500 is for AAA and AA. And in fact, in NBFCs, AAA and AA, they account for their portfolio of around 4,037 crores. Out of that, around 4,000 is in AAA and AA. In fact, in AAA, we have around 3,000 crores, and AA, we have around.
Sir, it will be helpful if you give the total AAA, AAA, because you know NBFC would include some PSUs and PSUs would include other corporates also. So okay. There will be a lot of.
Okay, that will provide no issue.
You can drop a mail wherever you require some granular details. You can drop mails on our investor relations at jkbmail.com.
I will do that. You have been very responsive. You know, it's very helpful. I've been in touch with you, so it's very helpful. Thank you.
The next question is from the line of Manish Oswal from Nirmal Bang. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. Most of the questions have been answered. Only one question on the operating expenses side. Since our revenue has decreased because of the COVID situation, what is the trend we are seeing in the operating expenses side? Because when I compare to the other banks, the operating expenses on YOY, we are still on the positive side. So what is happening on that side and what is the trend going ahead?
No, it's not like that. You see, it is only the employee cost that is positive. Otherwise, if you take other OPEX, so that is excluding the employee cost, it is 12% down on YOY basis, and if you take sequential quarter over quarter, it is 22% down against the March quarter.
Okay. And secondly, sir, on the capital raise, equity capital raise, the first tranche would be size of 1,000 crores or something of that sort, or it can be lower than that?
It will be lower than that. Definitely, it will be lower than that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The last question, please.
Yes, the last question is from the line of Bhavik Shah from BNK Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. So, thanks for the opportunity. So, I just wanted to clarify a couple of things. So, the wage provision that has been done in the quarter has been at the rate of what? So now, wages have been factored at 12% or more than that?
No, there's the agreement actually between IBA and the bank unions. It has been agreed that 15% will be the wage hike.
Okay, and we are starting in 15%.
So, yeah, exactly. So that's why this there has been a bigger provision during this quarter of 80 crores last year. During the last full year, we had made provision of 176 crores. And that's why we had to make a higher provision of 80 crores during this quarter, taking this 15% into account.
Okay. And, sir, so while explaining the capital raise plan, you mentioned first you will target PNB MetLife stake, where you will get around 360 crores. And so, yeah. What would be the other after that? What would be your plan before infusion from government?
After that, yeah, we have actually planned this ESPS because the employees will be getting these the arrears and other things, and we are targeting, and it will also act like a sweat equity, issuing sweat equity to the employees. Ensuring their further stake, though they are very loyal, and this it has been the association has been very strong with the bank, no attrition at all. So definitely we want to have their sweat equity also in this. So it will be the second, it will be the ESPS. Out of that, through that also we will be targeting some 250 crores. So almost 600 crores will be, we should be able to garner through these two options only.
Sir, when is PNB MetLife expected to complete?
Yes, we are actually exploring this. There's a price exploration, price discovery. It is happening as on date, and we are in touch with a couple of people also. And we expect good, better rate, more than over 60 rupees on that per share. So it is already being contemplated. It is already under process.
Okay. And sir, just a couple of minutes back, you mentioned there will be totally. There will be a further requirement of provision of around 500 crores. Sir, for that, sir, what kind of slippage estimates have you taken?
Pardon, we couldn't get the question.
Sir, a couple of minutes back, you mentioned there will be provision in the next 3 quarters of around 500 crores, 540 to 530 crores.
Yeah, 500 crores, yeah.
So what kind of slippages have you factored in?
It is actually like the citrus, like the SME portfolio, like we had, we were talking about the slippages that we are actually expecting, though we are taking those conservative estimates over there. And again, in that 500 crores is a major portion, is the aging provision. There's the NPAs that already exist in the book, and they get from one category to the other category. They get downgraded from one category of NPA to the other category. There is requirement of additional provisions. Even those may not materialize, because if you get a recovery prior to that, if the account is upgraded, if there is a, so there are so many things. This is the amount that is actually, if nothing happens to those accounts, then we will have to provide that much of amount. But if there is a recovery, if there is an upgrade, even that amount will be smaller.
Okay, okay. And sir, just one last clarification. Sir, account which were under standstill, asset classification benefit standstill, was 3,000 crore at the end of June. And at the end of August, it is 2,000 crore.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Sir, thank you. Sir, so
what is the RWA?
Sorry.
Yes, please.
Sir, what is the RWA amount in rupees billion?
Didn't get that, yeah?
Oh, so risk-weighted asset amount.
Oh, risk-weighted asset.
RWA. Yeah. So RWA is as on June, they still at as on March, these were 68,586 crores. As on June, they are 69,621. And in terms of proportion,
hello.
Yes, sir.
Did you get that figure?
I didn't get the March figure.
Yeah, the March figure is 68,586.
Okay. And June is 69,600 crores.
Yeah, 69,621. Just a marginal increase.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. As there are no further questions, I would now like to hand the conference over to the management for closing comments.
I, on behalf of the management, we appreciate the concern conveyed during the last 1 hour. But I assure you, the future, particularly the Q3 and Q4, will be better placed. And whatever the problem we are having regarding the capital growth and the recovery, as the activity, business activity in the J&K duty as well as the rest of India also, day by day they are improving. With the result, the position of our bank, J&K Bank, in the J&K state, because we are having most large chunk of the business in the J&K, and I assure you, the better result will prevail, particularly in the Q2 and Q3, ultimately, last quarter of this financial year. Thank you very much for the patience and for the reports you have given to us.
Thank you. On behalf of Prabhudas Leeladhar Private Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.
Thank you.